Are you struggling to wheelie your motorcycle? Do your friends poke fun when you can't quite get it up and keep it there? Well, help is at hand with KTM's new 5-stage wheelie control. It will let you become the hero you've always wanted to be. All this for just £19,599.
Terms and conditions apply. Tech back expires after 1,000 miles and you have to pay another £1,000 to reinstall it.
Everyone loves a good wheelie, whether it's doing one yourself or watching somebody else do one. I know I was inspired by Kevin Schwantz and Wayne Gardner back in those bad old 500cc Grand Prix days, and I've been obsessed with wheelies ever since. My first ones were in a Kawasaki AR80 with my legs dangling behind, but now you can jump on a KTM Superduke 1390R, which has got 5-stage wheelie control, and in theory it should help you wheelie without you really having to do anything. So anti-wheelie on a road bike isn't really anything new, but KTM have had a little bit of fun with the anti-wheelie control on the Superduke. So it's 5 stages and they've put a nice little graphic on the colour dash which shows the Superduke in its various stages of wheelie. So stage one is very low, then you've got a low wheelie, then you've got a medium, a high and a very high, and then an off. And despite all of that, there really are 5 things you need to know about the anti-wheelie system on this bike. The first of which is that you can still flip it. So the anti-wheelie on this bike basically works with the IMU, the internal gyro, which can sense how far back it's going, and the throttle with the ride-by-wire. And it will hold a wheelie at that angle if you're powering out of a corner, for example. If you instigate a wheelie, as you would if you were kind of showing off down this runway, and flick the clutch to bring it up, then the bike, if it comes up too fast, won't brake for you. So you could still flip it if you accelerate and dump the clutch too hard. Number two, you can't actually hold a balance point wheelie with this wheelie control. So I've been testing it and the lower wheelie settings keep the bike at quite a mild angle. The very high, when you first try very high, comes up quite a lot, but it stops short of the balance point. So even on the very high setting, your wheelie will only last as long as the revs last, and you need to turn it completely off if you want to balance. Number three, and this is a really good point. One of the most dangerous parts of a wheelie is coming down from a wheelie. Quite often you can be up there on the back wheel enjoying yourself and then suddenly it occurs to you that you've got to bring this down at some point. And if it comes down too fast or at an angle, then you're going to run into problems. So the good thing about the anti-wheelie on this bike is that it doesn't just cut the power, it starts to blend the power off to bring the front wheel back down to terra firma, nice and gently, and then you can go on your way. Number four. Although you can't do balance point wheelies with this wheelie control, it gives you the feel of what a real wheelie feels like in kind of relative safety. So if you've got an airfield to play with like this, you can get the sense of what that front wheel feels like when it starts to go light, because it's quite an alien feeling. Even having the front wheel off the ground 2 inches feels like you're gonna flip it. So if you can kind of get used to the wheelie control with the electronics, at some point, you'll have the confidence to do a real wheelie, turn the wheelie control off, and just keep on trucking. And finally, number five, the wheelie control on this bike is there for a serious reason, really. Not to play about on airfields. It's designed to make the KTM faster around a racetrack. And it does that perfectly. So, especially with a naked bike like this, it's got a true 180 bhp at the back wheel. When you come out of slow corners, first, second, third, probably even fourth on this bike, it's gonna want to wheelie. So that slows you down, that erodes your lap time. So there's ways to counter that without wheelie control. You can ease off the throttle, but then that's gonna slow you down. You can stamp on the back brake, which does work. You can stand up on the pegs and put all your weight over the front, which works as well. But all of those things take effort and can ruin your lap time. So having a wheelie control there to help you and something that's so sophisticated and smooth really is a big asset. And in terms of where to set it for the perfect lap time, well, the lower two modes, help the front wheel hover a little bit, but they pull back the power too much. If its wheelie's too high, that will slow you down as well. So kind of the medium to low mode on this bike will let the front wheel maybe hover about this high, and it will give you excellent acceleration. The electronics won't be holding you back, and hopefully you'll put in a great lap time.